Okay, now we're ready to analyze the characteristic impedance right here at O1, and we're going to plot that on the Smith chart. So let's take Z1 at O1 and normalize it by eta 1. The value that we will get is 0.12 plus J.06. Remember, this is now normalized. There are no ohms. So let's plot that one on the Smith chart also. Real part of 0.1, an imaginary part of 0.06 is going to be right about there. So this is Z1 at O1. Now the thing that we need is the reflection coefficient. So let's draw our line right here. And then down here on the reflection coefficient axis, let's draw the magnitude of the reflection coefficient right there. And the magnitude of the reflection coefficient is 0.0, sorry, it's about 0.8, not 0.08, it's about 0.8. And then we need to find the phase of the reflection coefficient. So we're going to read that right here. The angle of the reflection coefficient is about 68 degrees. So now we know the reflection coefficient at O1, which is the major reflection coefficient we need to know to understand what reflected field is coming back in this direction, is 0.8 at an angle of 68 degrees. Now let's review what we did. We started out with a three-layer media that may or may not have had lossy components. We calculated the constants, that means alpha and beta and eta, and also the wavelengths in each of those regions. We started right here at 0.03. We calculated the characteristic impedance, which is eta 3. We then used ohms to jump the boundary over to O2. We plotted that on a Smith chart, normalized it, rotated it a distance minus D2 until we got over here to this point, and then we calculated the attenuation using the reflection coefficient. We plotted our value at minus D2. We then had to get that off the Smith chart again, calculating the impedance, to jump the boundary and get to 0.01. Now there's one other thing that I would like to also show you. Okay, there's one other thing about getting the reflection coefficients is that if you have just a two-layer region where you have eta 1 here and eta 2 there, there's a very easy way of finding the reflection coefficient, and that is that the reflection coefficient, which is also going to be right here at O1, is going to be eta 2 minus eta 1 over eta 2 plus eta 1. So, nice, easy reflection coefficient. Now, in the next video, we're going to talk about how to use the reflection coefficients to find the fields in a two- or three-layer lossy region.